Good morning. So like Maria said, my name is Sandra. I'm living in the Netherlands. I am part of Breakthrough Foundation. And Breakthrough Foundation is supporting Tilburg City of Learning. And Tilburg City of Learning, as we see it, is also a learning platform where young people can find their opportunities that connects with their interests. Here you see a very nice picture of the beautiful station in Tilburg, a very nice station. And what I will start first with is that I want to introduce you the Youth Co-Design Tilburg City of Learning project. And that's a project that is also funded by Erasmus Plus, and where we are working on youth participation for 2 years with young people and with young people co-managing in the project also. So there's a very big part of participation in the project. In this project, young people from Tilburg will do youth consultations. So they have done interviews with young people about their lives in Tilburg. What do they face? How were they learning? How are they learning? What do they see in the future in 2030? So we have done, or young people have done, very in-depth interviews with other young people. So what we want to do, which is connected with this, or what we are doing, which is connected with this project, is that we as organization want to integrate digital literacy development from young people in our youth work projects. So what we are very much looking for in all the projects that we are running is that we are supporting young people with a digital literacy program. If you look at in this project, we are searching for narratives from young people in Tilburg and how they see the future, how they are can be role models for the next young people who are following up in the same age as they are. And we, together with young people, after deciding what is needed and not there yet in Tilburg City of Learning, they will develop resources and activities for your other young people in Tilburg. And we are doing that with a group of young people that is long-term connected with Tilburg City of Learning. So we are will also support them via a leadership training course to be the lead learner, be the role model for other young people in their city. What the youth team will do is deliver 5 workshops about how to use Tilburg City of Learning, which is the digital platform. And what we see is that young people are easy to it's easy to understand the Tilburg City of Learning platform, but sometimes it's more difficult for the adults who will also post activities on the platform to use the digital tools that they are using, that they want to use. So they are will deliver 5 workshops. They also will create 10 learning pathways, and at the moment young people have in this project created 5 learning pathways themselves. So I will show you later on one of them. And again, then we are sharing with young people and educating young people in how to use this digital learning platform and all the tools around. They will promote the activities and earning open badges. So open badges are, as we use them in this project, as a gamification tool for guiding the learning process, but also at the same time recognizing the learning via an open badge. And they are at the moment also joining virtual exchanges, so online virtual exchanges, where we also again support the young people with how to behave, what are the do's and don'ts on during a virtual exchange, an online meeting with other young people in Europe, and etc. What you see here on the right is one of the activities that young people have developed themselves. So this is Get Future Fit. What young people really want is that here you see the Tilburg City of Learning platform. And what they want is that young people to support other young people to be future fit. What you see here is in Dutch. I put the English version of the platform, but also in Dutch, the text is there still because the young people want to understand it, Dutch young people. And so this playlist, and a playlist is a set of activities, will guide young people to a future perspective. So what do they want to do in the future and where do they want to be? If you see here, for example, one of the items that young people really wanted to have inside is digital to fill in worksheet. So if you click on these boxes, then people can type in themselves what they want, and then it will be a digital tool where they, which they can change later. And so it is a PDF where young people can type in and develop their whole route towards 2030. This is all based, this whole system, so you can see here the activities. This whole playlist consists of about 5 activities. So one is the Future Fit worksheet. The second one is the future skills. So what are future skills? And if you look here inside this activity, they talk about 5 skill zones. And in this skill zone, and this is created by Institute for the Future, these are the global youth skills. So the young people decided to connect with the global youth skills, which are make yourself known, make sense, keep it going, befriend the machines, and build your tribe. So again, as youth org organization, we included the befriend the machines, which is a digital literacy part. Befriend the machines is one of the skill zones that young people want to work on. And they are still searching for what is befriend the machines. So in 2030, what do we need to know? What do we need to be able to do? And what global youth skills says is that every young person at least needs to find ways to collaborate with digital machines, all kind of machines, working for them over the next decades. So young people will work together with machines or digital machines, but also machines will work for young people. And sometimes, for example, you can even think about, will AI be, or a robot will be part of your team? So if you think about collaboration, nowadays we are only thinking about collaboration between people. So you have a team meeting with the lonely people inside. But what if AI will join you in your team, and how to collaborate in a team with AI involved? Those are things that we are talking right now together with young people in Tilburg. And what also is very important is that each young person needs to find their own unique role in this process, in this global human machine. Because for everyone, the future will look different, and it needs to have a personalized path. What we have done in these activities also to support the Befriend the Machines skill zone is, in the activities that are on Tilburg City of Learning, we have included badges, and also we have included Befriend the Machines open badges where activities are behind. So there are 3 in this system. There are 3 open badges: A1 IQ, digital fluency, and simulated actions. And involved are activities in these activities are how to chat with an assistant, a digital assistant. How are you doing that? Do you know which words you are using? What is AI and how to do emotional intelligence, for example, together with computers or AI, and simulated actions. When young people have earned these 3 badges, then they will earn a bigger badge, which is the Befriend the Machines badge, the master badge in this program. For the global youth skills, you can see here that the badge system is not only consistent about this Befriend the Machine system, but all the 5 skill zones are in here. And the skill zones, so it's not one skill, or it is not one competence, but it is a skill zone where different skills are fit in one skill zone. And because of the personalized learning path that young people want to create, these skills are also different for each person. And that not only, so it is one Befriend the Machine master badge, but also a Make Yourself Known master badge, Make Sense master badge, Build Your Crew master badge, and a Keep It Going master badge. What are we learning at the moment for when we are using Cities of Learning together with young people? The most important part that for us is that we need to start trying out with young people. That's the only way how we learn as organization. So young people need to use it. They are the users, so they need to like the platform that we are using. Otherwise, they will not use it. they really like to be involved in the designing of the activities and the open badges. So they are together with experts designing these activities. Also, they say themselves, don't listen too much to what organizations need, because there's a difference in what organizations, sometimes there's a difference in what organizations want and need and what young people want. That is what we are trying to do, at least in Tilburg, City of Learning. And what we learn from this project is that we need to think outside the existing box, especially because we are learning towards 2030 and we don't know yet how 2030 will look like. We need to invent and invest and do research and just try out. When we are talking with young people about the open badges, there are also some recommendations from them. Is there in the Netherlands, what the Dutch formal education really wants and what the business field really wants is that they want to recognize competences gained in their own words. Formal education and the business field wants to recognize what young people have learned outside school. And what we are trying out right now is that we connect with the existing competence frameworks, recognize and connect with formal education and the business field. Also, what we hear from young people is that we need to look at who the young people are, also how to issue the badges. So in what way we issue badges depends on the target group. So it is always also, again, this personalized route that we are searching for. And those were my slides and our project that is still running until for the next 1.5 years. Thank you.